Umoja is a powerful exhibition by local photographer Chris Dade, who brought back from street kids in Kenya a message of brotherhood and hope.
Umoja is a Swahili word that means unity. And that's something that's always interested me. After I went back into photography when things kind of fell away in England and there was less money around, started traveling the world with my camera, and I was really looking for that sense of community and unity. That's something that's very close to my heart. And what's interesting about this exhibition is that I found it in the most unlikeliest of places, which was in a safe house for street children in Kenya. There's 300,000 kids that live in Kenya on the streets. Umoja means a lot to me because the exhibition isn't an easy exhibition. It's an exhibition that is kind of tells the difficult story of street children, but it also talks about how they've turned their life from living in gangs into a brotherhood in a safe house. And it's a story of hope. So the first part of it is actually talking about a lot of the issues for street children, because it's not just an issue in Kenya, it's globally. You'll look at the first part of the exhibition, there's a lot of kids making direct eye contact with the camera. All of the text is written by the young people, and yeah, it's very powerful stuff as well about glue addiction and about why they fall into gangs and glue addiction just in order to survive. The second half of it, though, is much more of a story of hope. It's about the safe house, as I said, like how they've turned like this gang life into a brotherhood. There's a loneliness epidemic in the UK. It's a real issue here. And it's interesting that I went to Kenya and that's where I found some unity was there. So I think we've got a lot to learn from what these young people are saying. I mean, they very much talk about trauma. They very much talk about the most difficult things in life. But out of that, they've kind of blossomed into something really special. They've realized almost like the secret to life, which I agree is about unity. It's about coming together and learning to be a community together. I think the best things in life just fall together. It was pretty effortless. It took time and energy, but I think the best things just unfold naturally, and it did unfold naturally, thank goodness. I linked in with the boys and I made sure that they had like a major say in everything that was being done. They wanted a lot of pictures of them in education and succeeding, not just of the boys on the street, to show that actually these are kids that have a lot of skills, a lot of ability, if only they're just given the chance and seen in a different light. You see the real devastation, because that's the reality of life. Living on the streets is devastating. As one of the boys put it, it's a war zone out there, you know? But also they're saying, you know, out of this, the hope. People feel very inspired by it. The fact that, you know, I think sometimes we can get caught up in our drama of our lives, and then when you see some of the extremes out in the world, it just helps you have a reality check to think, well, out of some of the trauma that's coming in my life, I can be like these guys, I can really make something of it. I think sometimes the hardest time in life when you fall to your knees is the time that you're really pushed to open the heart and to live in a different way.
The exhibition will be open at St. Augustine Church only until the 11th of October, but all the images and the related book will be available at www.harambeeforkenya.org. All profits will go to Harambee for Kenya, helping street children to start a new life. This is Willy Ranieri for Latest TV News.